Welcome to Emanuel Lutheran Church for this wired worship. We are so glad to have you joining us for worship today. We long for the time when we can one day gather together in the sanctuary, but until that time, we are grateful for this opportunity. If you're new to our community, please check out our webpage or our Facebook page and see the ways that you can become connected in our ministry through our food pantry, through prayer, through connection. And on Wednesdays, we have a Zoom worship of Holden Vespers that you're invited to join us for. We are glad to have you worshiping with us and hope that you feel God's presence today. We confess our sins to God and hear the words of grace and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, whose voice is upon the water, whose mercy is poured out upon all people, whose goodness cascades over all creation. Amen. Let us confess our sin, trusting in the abundant grace of God. Holy God, you search us and know us. You are acquainted with all our ways. We confess that our hearts are burdened by sin, our own sins, and the broken systems that bind us. We turn inward, failing to follow your outward way of love. We distrust those who are not like us. We exploit the earth and its resources and fail to consider generations to come. Forgive us, gracious God, for all we have done and left undone. Even before the words are on our tongues, you know them. Receive them in your divine mercy. Amen. How vast is God's grace! Through the power and the promise of Christ Jesus, our sins are washed away, and we are claimed as God's own beloved. Indeed, we are forgiven. In the wake of God's forgiveness, we are called to be the beloved community, living out Christ's justice and the Spirit's reconciling peace. Amen. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Everlasting God, you give strength to the weak and power to the faint. Make us agents of your healing and wholeness, that your good news may be made known to the ends of your creation. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Have you not known? Have you not heard? Has it not been told you from the beginning? Have you not understood from the foundations of the earth? It is he who sits above the circle of the earth, and its inhabitants are like grasshoppers, who stretches out the heavens like a curtain and spreads them like a tent to live in, who brings princes to naught and makes the rulers of the earth as nothing. Scarcely are they planted, scarcely sown. Scarcely has their stem taken root in the earth, when he blows upon them and they wither, and the tempest carries them off like stubble. To whom then will you compare me? Or who is my equal, says the Holy One? Lift up your eyes on high and see. Who created these? He who brings out their host and numbers them, calling them all by name, because he is great in strength, mighty in power. Not one is missing. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God? Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
Great is the Lord, he is holy and just, by his power we trust in his love. Great is the Lord, he is holy and just, by his power we trust in his love. Hallelujah, how good it is to sing praises to our God. How pleasant it is to honor God with praise. The Lord rebuilds Jerusalem and gathers the exiles of Israel. The Lord heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. The Lord counts the number of the stars and calls them all by their mighty in power. There is no limit to God's wisdom. The Lord lifts up the lowly, but casts the wicked to the ground. Sing to the Lord with thanksgiving. Make the music upon the harp to our God. Covers the heavens with clouds and prepares rain for the earth, making grass to grow upon the mountains. Great is the Lord, he is holy and just, by his power we trust in his love. God provides food for the cattle and for the young ravens when they cry. God is not impressed by the might of a horse, and has no pleasure in the speed of a runner, but finds pleasure in those who fear the Lord, in those who await God's steadfast love. Alleluia.
The Gospel according to St. Mark, the first chapter. As soon as Jesus and his disciples left the synagogue after he had cast out the demon, they entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Now, Simon's mother-in-law was in bed sick with a fever, and they told him about her at once. Jesus came and took her by the hand and lifted her up. Then the fever left her, and she began to serve them. That evening, at sunset, they brought to him all who were sick or possessed with demons, and the whole city was gathered around the door. And he cured many who were sick with various diseases, and cast out many demons, and he would not permit the demons to speak, because they knew him. In the morning, while it was very dark, Jesus got up and went out to a deserted place, and there he prayed. And Simon and his companions hunted for him. And when they found him, they said, "Everyone is searching for you." Jesus answered, "Let us go on to the neighboring towns, so that I may proclaim the message there also. For that is what I came here to do." And he went throughout Galilee, proclaiming the message in their synagogues, and casting out demons. This is the gospel of our Lord. Exile. Not being able to be with your community. Being alone. Separated. Not part of the world that you were a part of before. It had been 70 long years for the people of Judah. Exiled in Babylon, waiting to return home to Jerusalem. And finally, finally it looks like it might be a possibility. But they feel lost, alienated, even questioning where God was and where God is. And does God still care? That's what is going on in the lesson today from Isaiah. The 40th chapter is the beginning of the second part of Isaiah. The first part is before they go into exile. And these chapters are in 2nd Isaiah are just as the people are about to return home. And it begins with questions and concerns. They have feel like they've been forgotten. It's like they have theological amnesia. They've been isolated so long, they wonder, is God still there? Does God still care? Those questions come to them, and the response from God is overwhelming. I am the Lord. I care for you. I love you. You are my people. I am greater than any kind of general. I am the creator of the earth. I am the maker of the world. And I have not forgotten you. I have not abandoned you. You are mine, and I am with you. Those words come to us today as well, as we are in the midst of exile ourselves. It's been a long year. Many of us are weary and overwhelmed. So much has happened. We've been separated. We struggle. And sometimes we wonder where God is in the midst of this struggle. And how can we keep going on? I mean, the news keeps coming on, and there's visions of hope, and then worry that things won't work out. It's an up and down roller coaster ride. And so we wait, and we wonder. And we know, like the people of Judah, as they were returning to Jerusalem after 70 years, that the Jerusalem that they know doesn't exist anymore. And for us, especially in a church community, what we had, well, it's different. We've lost people. We've had death. There's fear. And what are we going back to? How do we cope? We cope. We cope by knowing that the Lord God who created the world, who created the earth, never, never has amnesia toward us. We may forget, just like the people of Judah had forgotten, but God never forgets. God holds on. I like the way that this passage is read in Eugene Peterson's The Message. The last part of it, beginning with verse 27, as they're going back and forth and wondering where God is, and God has already explained that God is the creator of the world. And then goes on to say, why would you ever complain, O Jacob, or whine, O Israel, saying, God has lost track of me. God doesn't care what happens to me. Don't you know anything? Haven't you been listening? God doesn't come and go. God lasts. God is the creator of all you see or imagine. And God doesn't get tired, doesn't pause to catch the breath. And God knows everything, inside and out. God energizes those who get tired and gives fresh strength to dropouts. For even young people tire and drop out. Young folk in their prime stumble and fall. But those who wait upon the Lord will renew their strength. They will mount up with wings like an eagle. They will run and not be weary, and they will walk and not faint. Those were words of hope to the people of Judah as they felt like they were fainting after 70 long years in exile. And those words come to us as well. And what they speak to is a God who never forgets, who never has amnesia. We may feel like we're lost and alone and bereft, but God is with us. And I love the gradations in this one, because it talks about how sometimes you might feel as if you were soaring like an eagle, and sometimes you're running without being weary. But for me, the most important part is that last part. Walk and not faint. Because sometimes that's all we can do. There are people in the midst of grief, in the midst of pain, in the midst of isolation, that can't soar and see the horizon and see what lies behind. They can't run and watch as things pass. Sometimes all that matters is seeing to the next minute, the next hour, the next day, bit by bit, holding on. And holding on to this promise that when God walks with us, we walk and we don't faint. That is the hope of the scripture, and that is the hope that we have to hold on to, because a lot of us are weary. A lot of us just feel like we're going through the motions. I know there's a heaviness sometimes, a heaviness of heart, because we feel like we're in exile. We can't gather with others. We can't surround ourselves with loved ones. And so in the midst of all of that, we feel so tired. And yeah, as the scripture reminds us, everyone gets tired. We live in a society that sometimes tells us that we're supposed to pull ourselves up by our bootstraps. But that's not what God says to us. See, God tells us that it's not about our bootstraps that we lift ourselves up by, but rather God who walks with us and who lifts us up, who raises us up when we feel like we are going to drop. We do not have to have it all, and we don't need to have it all within us, because we serve and we love and have a God who has a personal relationship with us, and this God is the creator of the whole world. So it's vast and it's personal. God does not cause all of the brokenness. God does not lead to exile. But when we are with God, we can never be exiled from the love of God and the promise to sustain us in the midst of whatever burden we are bearing. This text is such an important text to so many of us, because it is the realization of a promise of a God who will let us soar and will allow us to run, but most importantly, who will not let us fall over, who will hold us up when we have no longer any strength, who cares, who loves. Right now, it's hard. These are tough times. Isolation, fear, uncertainty. Much like the people who heard this text. But God doesn't lose track of us. God doesn't forget about us. Our God loves us. Loved us enough to raise us up. To raise us up from our own brokenness and pain. And so, whatever you're struggling with, whatever burden you feel is just too much to bear, know that you don't bear it alone. We bear it together in community as we care and love for each other, even from a distance. And we bear it with God, who walks with us, who goes with us, who never leaves or abandons us. Some days walking without fainting, getting to the next minute,
That's all we need. Because then there'll be another minute and another, and God will still be present and surround us in that. We may grow weary. Many of us are. But God does not weary. God does not forget. God holds on and never, never lets us go. So whatever burden you're bearing, whatever challenge you're facing, you don't walk alone. You walk with God, even when you feel in exile. And when we walk with God, we know that we will be led to the promised land. Amen.
Guided by Christ, made known to the nations, let us offer our prayers for the church, the world, and all people in need. Gracious Heavenly God, as we deal with a time of exile, as we deal with a time where we might wonder where you are, remind us of your presence, walking with us, supporting us, sustaining us. Thank you for letting us know that we do not walk alone, that you journey with us and give us strength, even as we return to a place that is different than the one that we came from. Let us pray. Have mercy, O God. For creation, for insects in the grass, clouds on the mountains, cattle and rainwater they drink, for the humility to take our place among all creatures of the earth, and to remember that you are the Creator God. Let us pray. Have mercy, O God. For all the nations, for all who lead in cities and towns, states and countries, for community organizers, school officials, and CEOs, for international health organizations that in times of trial, fear, or hopelessness, they find freedom in service to those most in need, and for wisdom, for peace, and for your presence. Let us pray. Have mercy, O God, for all who are wearied by life's burdens, for those who are poor, for those who are lacking supportive relationships, for those crushed by debt, for those struggling with chronic pain or other sicknesses, for those exhausted from overwork or stress, for those isolated and alone because of the pandemic, and for all who cry out to you. Especially today, we lift up to you Janice, Les, David, Amy, Kathleen, Barbara, Peggy, Carol, Karen, Chris, and Corrine. Lord God, and all those we name now in our hearts before you. Let us pray. Have mercy, O God. For this congregation, for outreach and social ministries centered here, especially for those who work in our food pantry, in our outreach, delivering food at a time when this becomes a necessity for the surrounding area, for ministries of companionship and support, for those who call upon you, for the young people who are here seeking to struggle as we deal with a pandemic, that they might continue to grow in knowledge of you. Help us to continue to be in the city for good. Let us pray. Have mercy, O God. In thanksgiving for the faithful departed, who were called by name and now rest from their labors, we especially lift up to you Barbara Erskine, who was laid to rest on Friday, that her life may serve as a witness to the goodness of God. Let us pray. Have mercy, O God. Merciful God, hear the prayers of your people, spoken or silent, for the sake of the one who dwells among us, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you. May you know God's peace wherever you are, whoever you're surrounded by, and may you know that God is indeed with you. This time we will have an offering piece of music, and during that time I invite you to prayerfully reflect on how God has been responding to you during this time of exile, and recall how you might return to God as God has given to you. We appreciate the checks that are sent to the church as well as the online donations that allow us to continue ministry even when we are in a time of exile. Your tithes and offerings. Thank you.
Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Receive the benediction. God, the Creator, strengthen you. Jesus, the Beloved, fill you. And the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, keep you in peace. Amen. Go in peace. Be the light of Christ. Thanks be to God. Amen.